COVID-19 severity possibly affected by immune response timing. Researchers from the Keck School of Medicine of University of Southern California have found that temporarily suppressing the body's immune response in the early stages of coronavirus infection may prevent the development of more severe symptoms. The paper, published in the Journal of Medical Virology, details the difference of progression between COVID-19 and the flu, and how the slow progression of COVID-19 combined with immune response can affect the body. Co-author Sean Du said, "Based on the results of the mathematical modeling, we propose a counterintuitive idea that a short regimen of a proper immunosuppressant drug applied early in the disease process may improve a patient's outcome. The appropriate suppressive agent can help delay the body's adaptive immune response, preventing it from interfering with the innate immune response. This would then trigger faster elimination of the virus and the infected cells." The South China Morning Post explains that the human immune system responds to invasive pathogens in either an innate or adaptive way. The innate immune response activates quickly to attack non-specific foreign cells in the body, while the adaptive immune response attacks a specific type of pathogen if it is still detected in the body days later. According to Science Daily, the interaction between the two types of immune response can cause a patient's immune system to go into overdrive. Du and his fellow researchers used the target cell limited model, a model used to understand the dynamics of viral infections, to analyze innate and adaptive response in both COVID-19 and flu patients. While the flu attacks and kills target cells on the surface of the upper respiratory system in 2 to 3 days, COVID-19 has an incubation period of 6 days and progresses much more slowly. Its target cells also reside in the entire respiratory system. The study's findings suggest that patients' adaptive immune response may be kicking in too early, affecting the ability of their innate immune response to attack most of the virus. Co-author Wei-Ming Yuan said, "The longer duration of viral activity may lead to an overreaction of the immune system, called a cytokine storm, which kills healthy cells, causing tissue damage." The researchers propose that patients who report two waves of COVID-19 may just be experiencing the interaction between the two immune responses.